Good morning, everyone. My name is Unai Ansejo, and today myself and my partners, François Derbaix and Ramón Blanco, are going to present you the financial results of Indexa Capital Group of the year 2023. The roadmap for today is, first, we are going to do a brief executive summary of what has happened in 2023. Then we are going to talk a bit about the key performance indicators. Then we are going to show you the financial results. Then we are going to talk a bit more about the main achievements that we have done in the last year. And then we are going to talk about the next steps that we have ahead of us. So the main title of these results are that Indexa Capital Group has acquired its first company in France. Its name is Caravel, and we have completed the transaction in March 2024. The revenues have grown 23% in 2023 versus 2022. And the net income has increased 3% from €390,000 to €410,000 in 2023. The main KPIs and financials for each individual company are as follows. Indexa Capital AB has seen its assets under management increased 38% in the last 12 months. That is more than €500 million in the last 12 months. The final number of assets under management is now above €2 billion. Of these €500 million, €330 million are net inflows, and €226 million are the market growth that we have seen in the last year. In Bwater Asset Management, the assets under management have grown 19%, and the revenues have increased 13%. And in Indexa Courtier, we have just begun operations last year, and the assets under management have grown from zero to more than €200,000. Our main achievements in the last year have been in Indexa Capital AB. We have launched the safety cushion, where clients can choose to invest their short-term money. We have won, along with Caser, a public tender for the public promotion of employment pension plans in Spain. That means that we are one of the five companies that have been chosen to manage those public funds. And we have also launched an employment pension plan for the self-employed. In Bwater Asset Management, we have continued investing in the following companies: Indemnízame, Nailed It, Lyko Cosmetics, and El Avocado. And we have also done the first closing of Bwater to FCRE. And in Indexa Courtier, we have launched and we have acquired our first customers. And Caravel, which is the company that we just acquired in 2024, has begun operations with us. So the next slide is a brief summary of the main numbers of our year 2023. First, revenues have increased 23%, and net income has increased 3%, up to €410,000. As you may have seen, revenues have grown much more than net income in 2023. And the reason behind that is that we have seen two exceptional costs in 2023 that were not in 2022. And those are the corporate income taxes and the costs of the listing in the BME Growth Market. So why costs have risen more than revenues in 2023? First, BME Growth listing one-off cost of €150,000, equivalent to 51% of the net income growth. And second, the corporate income tax of €200,000 in 2023 versus zero the previous year, when we were still compensating accumulated losses from previous years. So on a comparable basis, net income would have grown 92% above revenue growth, 23%, which shows the scalability of our business model. And now I'm going to let the word to my partner, François Derbaix, who is going to talk to you a bit more about Indexa Capital AB.
Thank you, Unai. Before going on with Indexa Capital AV, we may switch to the next page. I wanted to comment to everybody on the live stream that you may put your name on the to join the conversation. And there is a link upper left after putting your name where you have a chat icon and you may publish your questions or comments on the live chat. And we will attend the questions and the comments at the end of the presentation. Next page. Okay, thank you. Indexa Capital AV, as I mentioned, has grown quite well. It's plus 38% of AUMs last year. Of this plus 38%, part of it is from new investment from the customers and part of it is from the market evolution. So we grew 330 million, and that's what you see on the left part of the chart. 330 million of new investment, net new investment, and 226 of market increase. Worth to mention that this year, in 2024, we have already grown by 300 million. So we grew in the first 3 months of, in the first quarter of 2024, 300 million, which is more than half of what we did last year. We are growing, we are already profitable, and we are accelerating. On the left, on the right side, you have a table with the main KPIs of Indexa Capital. I will not go through all of them, but maybe the major one is the AUMs we already mentioned. The number of clients that grew 15% from 60,000 customers in 2022 to 69,000 customers in 2023. And worth to mention as well that we decreased the customer acquisition cost. That means the average we pay in marketing spend to acquire a new customer, and we reduced it drastically last year of 51%. So we went to a 22-month payback period. The payback period is the time we take us to get the fees to cover the acquisition cost. We went from 22 months of payback in 2022 to 16 months in 2023. If we can move to the next page. The portfolio returns for our customers, as expected, has been much higher than the benchmark. So what we do in this graph is to compare the profitability of the average portfolio. It's a portfolio number 6. It's a little more than 50% equity and the rest in bonds. And we compare it to the profitability of the similar or comparable Spanish mutual funds since the beginning of Indexa, since 2015. And until the end of last year, 2023. And what we see is that on a cumulated basis, our average portfolio has got a total return of 46%, while the benchmark, the average of the comparable mutual funds, got a profitability of 11% accumulated. So we compare this 45% to 46% accumulated for Indexa, with 11 of the benchmark, and we see that we have a 35 percentage points higher returns than the benchmark. So huge profitability difference that makes that our customers globally are very satisfied. They recommend Indexa and they help us to keep accelerating. We go to the next page. We can see the net inflows in our history. So the net inflow is the difference between a new investment by the customers and the withdrawals. So money in minus money out. And what we can see on this graph is the darker blue line is the total net inflow for Indexa. The lighter blue is the mutual funds portfolios. The orange line is the pension fund. And the rest are minor other products. And what we can see is that even in the highest drawdown of the market, so even during the COVID-19 market drawdown, or even in the Ukraine invasion market drawdown, even at those worst moments of the market, we kept net positive inflows, which is quite significant. Because at that time we were among the very few management companies having net positive inflows. In the beginning of 2024, so we finished 2023 with net inflows around 38 million, And now, in the beginning of this year, we are around 50 to 60 million per month net inflows. So actually, we keep accelerating. If you go to the next page, what we are showing is the cohort analysis. That's very useful for us because it helps us to see with how much investment the customer is starting to invest with us. So that's on the chart, each line is a cohort. That means a group of customers. The longer line, the blue, the darker blue line are the customers from 2016. So they have been with us more than 7 years. And what we see is that they started on average at 10,000 euro investment. They are investing on average 500 euro per month. And after 7 years, they have invested with us already 86,000 euro. What does that imply? It means that Indexa is growing a lot through new customer acquisition, but also with a compounding effect that the current investor, the current customers, keep investing more and more. And that's the explanation to our acceleration in the AUM growth. We can move to the next page. And on this one, we show a comparison, a ranking of financial entities in Spain that do portfolio management, discretionary portfolio management. So it's a very specific activity where the client are delegating to the financial institution the management of their portfolio. This is our main activity. And we see in this ranking that Indexa is the only independent player in the top 10. It's also the only recent player in the top 10. So we got there among large banks like Caixa Bank, BBVA, Santander, etc. And in only 8 years, close to 9 years now, we managed to get in the top 10 as the only independent player. We think it's important to be the only independent one because it allows us to offer the customers a better service with no conflict of interest. So without the typical conflict of interest of the large banking institutions or insurance group. So the message is we are growing, we are profitable, and we are accelerating. And now I pass the word to my partner Ramón, who is going to tell us a little bit more about Bwater Funds.
Thank you, François. Thank you, Unai. And good morning to everyone. Just to remind the audience that Bwater Asset Management is the unit of the group in which we invest in private equities, while at Indexa AV, we invest in basically liquid assets. At Bwater Asset Management, we invest in illiquid assets. Assets under management grew by 19% last year, which is a reasonable increase under very challenging conditions. Probably most of the audience knows that private equities decreased in value in the order of 30% last year. Revenues increased by 13%. We were able to reduce our losses as well. They decreased by 11%. In terms of number of managed funds, we increased the number by two. We incorporated a new mono investment fund because we invested in a company which is called Lico Cosmetics, which is basically an e-commerce of cosmetics over the internet. And we also managed to make the first closing of our second diversified fund, which is called Bwater 2 FCRA, which we are still commercializing. So if anyone wants to invest with us, they can give us a shout. Finally, the unrealized capital gains, which is basically the theoretical capital gains that we would obtain if we sold our portfolio at that moment, increased by 34%, which, as I said at the beginning, it's a solid result given the fact that most valuation for private equities decreased on average by 30% in 2023. And I'm going to give back the word to Unai, who is going to explain you why and how we are growing. We are profitable, and more important than that, we are accelerating.
So thank you, Ramón. So now we are going to move forward to the financial results of the last year, 2023. First, in this slide, we are showing you the consolidated profit and loss statement of Indexa Capital Group. The main numbers there are that the revenues have increased 23% up to 4.8 million euros. The headcount costs have also grown 24% to 1.7 million, and the general costs have also increased 24% to 2.1 million euros. So that altogether, the consolidated net income has increased 3% up to 110,000 euros. If we move forward to the consolidated assets and liabilities and equity of Indexa Capital Group, in this slide we can see that the total assets have increased 11% up to 3.66 million euros, and the liabilities have increased 12% up to 1.80 million, and that the equity has increased 10% up to 2.5 million euros. In our next slide, now we are moving to our main achievements. We have already talked about this at the beginning of the presentation. So what I'm going to do now is to give the word back to François, who is going to explain a bit more about what we believe has been the biggest achievement in this year, which is has been the acquisition of Caravel.
Thank you, Unai. So what we when we went public on BME growth last year, we stated that part of the objective was to be able to acquire other competitors. We did a first acquisition 1 month ago of Caravel in France. Caravel is a courtier d'assurance. It means insurance broker with a similar activity to Indexa Courtier, our subsidiary in France, but with complementary products. So Indexa Courtier is offering a life insurance saving service, and Caravel is offering mostly a pension plan service, which is an insurance product in France. We think it's an important acquisition because it's an acquisition we made at a reasonable price. It's an acquisition we have with a price that we have paid in a net price of around 400,000 euros. And we have paid part in cash to the shareholders and part in vendor debt. Means that we still have to pay the second part of the price that will most probably be converted into Indexa Capital Group shares in the future. So we are testing this way of acquiring companies. We are looking at more acquisitions, hopefully, in one of our the markets we are present currently, which are mostly Spain, Belgium, and France. And we hope to develop an action book, I would say, to be able to do more acquisition and more integration in the future. Okay, maybe I give you the word for the
next steps.
The next steps.
Thank you. So our next steps are keeping the way that we are doing things. So we are growing, as you have seen. We want to keep being profitable, and we want to keep accelerating. And we are going to do so by automatizing almost all the processes and services that we can. We are going to keep innovating in products as we have done in the past to offer better services for our customers. We want to increase revenue more than costs and therefore grow profits. We want to reduce the total cost of our services for our customers as we continue to grow in total managed volume. So François has already told us that we are accelerating because we closed the year with 2 billion and we are already above 2.3 billion at the end of March. We want also to be very alert to possible opportunities for inorganic growth. And we want to increase our presence in France and Spain or Belgium. And in Bwater Asset Management, we want to keep finding and investing good private companies in the technology sector that are not listed, and that we want to invest in those mainly through secondary offerings. So in the next slide, this is a brief summary. We want to consolidate Spain. We want to increase our presence in France and Belgium. And we want to analyze strategic acquisitions in Europe and act as the sector consolidator. We believe that we are in the best position to do this long-term vision, because we are profitable, and that enables us to decide when and where we want to move. And second, we are growing, which adds more and more firepower to this vision. And now we are opening question and answer period. And for that, you in the Vimeo website, you have if you enter your name and you join the conversation, you can write your questions in English, French, Spanish, or really in the language that you want, and we will translate. So we
have to give a few seconds for the question to enter, because there is a little lag in the presentation. In the meantime, maybe I may comment something on the top of what we've commented before about the acceleration. We think that there are kind of three elements that are facilitating our acceleration in this year. The first one, of course, is the market, because the portfolio performance is doing well. So the customers are happy with their investment. We have close to 100%, almost 100% of the customers with net profitability on their accounts. So people are recommending us more, and the flywheel of Indexa is working better when the market is helping. That's the first positive element pushing us in our acceleration. The second one is that we reduced the minimum investment amount at the end of last year. So we reduced the minimum amount from 3,000 euro in the mutual funds portfolios to 2,000. And that means that we are opening a lot more accounts this year than last year. Actually, we did in the first quarter 88% more account openings than we did in the same period of the previous year. And the third one is that we have increased, to compensate a little bit the market investment reduction, we have increased the amount we manage without fees for the invited people. So we have this member get member program, giving a free an amount managed for free without the Indexa commission for the inviter and for the invited customer. And we increased this amount from 10,000 euro previously to 15,000, which also helps to the recommendation machine to accelerate. So between the market, between the minimum amount investment and the invitations, those three factors are explaining part of the acceleration of that we are seeing this year of 2024. We have a question from Pedro Diaz, De Capital Radio. The question is about macroeconomic outlook for this year. So maybe it's a question going more for Unai.
Yeah. So thank you for the question, Pedro. In the truth is that in Indexa Capital AV, we don't create macroeconomic perspectives, because we believe that it only makes sense to invest and to plan for the long term. So we really don't care whether this is going to be a good or bad macroeconomic year. We tell our clients that they should have portfolios that they can hold in the good, but also during the bad times. And therefore, macroeconomic conditions or even market conditions are not going to modify our asset allocation or the type of management that we do with our clients. So I'm sorry, but we have no view there in the macroeconomic outlook for this year or the next years.
Thank you. We're waiting to see if there is another question. So you may, as Unai mentioned, you may write your question in the language you want. If you do it in English, we'll answer in English. If you do it in French or in Spanish, we'll answer in two languages. There is a question from Xavier Núñez Romero regarding inorganic growth. How do you expect to extract synergies? Do you expect to keep brand names of acquired companies? Maybe I start with this one, and then maybe Ramón wants to add something. So it will depend on the acquisition. With the Carabel acquisition, the brands are very complementary, very different, with a different positioning. Carabel has a pure ESG, so environmental, social, and governance investment focus. Carabel is very specialized on the pension product, so savings for the retirement. And Carabel is reaching a much younger public than we have at Indexa Capital, and also much more feminine public. So Carabel has a majority of customers who are women, and Indexa has most of the financial service companies as a majority of men. So we think the complementarity is quite good enough to maintain the both brands, to maintain both offerings, to keep the offering of Carabel intact, so to let them have their own positioning. And that's the objective of this first acquisition. Now, for next acquisition, I would say it will depend on the company. If the company is very different or complementary with Indexa, we would probably go with a two-brand strategy per country. If the company has an offering quite similar to what we do at Indexa, then we would probably merge brands and merge also the front of the web page, the application, and so on under Indexa brand. Ramón, maybe you want to add something?
Yes, overall, we are aware that 50% of acquisitions on public listed equities destroy value. We are very aware of that. We're also very aware that normally when you make an acquisition, you need to do synergies. And we're also aware that co-synergies probably have a much higher likelihood to be turned into value creation than revenue synergies. We are aware, we know that. But then, you know, of course, in acquisitions, you go case by case, as François explained. In the case of Carabel, that was just finalized, we are going to maintain a separate brand because it makes sense in this case, because actually the value proposition of Carabel, which is very ESG focused, doesn't really fit with much more generalistic approach, which is the one that Indexa currently supports. And also in this in the case of Carabel is a very small organization, so there are hardly co-synergies that we can extract. And I would say that the biggest value added for ourselves is that we gain a top management team in France to develop our French strategy. We will see case by case, okay? But please rest assured that we are very aware that we need to create value with acquisitions.
Thank you. Let's see if there is another question coming. In the meantime, yes, maybe you mentioned the top management. What we have seen when we launched Indexa in France last year is that it's very hard to grow the company from abroad and to get a real local presence. So what we think is that by acquiring a company with already 2,000 customers, we are going to gain a couple of years of go-to-market development in this country. That's why the acquisition in France is much more strategic, actually, than an acquisition in Spain, for instance, because it makes a big difference for us in terms of customer base and also local positioning. There is a question from Hugo Calabo. Or Hugo Calabot, congratulations for your success. I see your value compared with traditional banks, but which are, in your opinion, your main strength compared with other new players that offer access to index funds in the Spanish market? You want to?
Yeah. Thank you for the question. Our main strengths, I would say, is that we have always been a company more indexed than other companies, which means that our portfolios don't have less bias than in other companies. Second, I would say that the size of Indexa is already so big in comparison with our competitors that we have benefits of size at this moment. Third, I would say that given the number of clients that we already have, this will make us possible to create new products and new services or more niche offerings that other competitors can offer at this time.
I think the question goes more to the self-catered, so Indexa versus self-catered. Direct access to the index funds and the customer managing its own portfolio.
Understood. So those are two different services, totally different services. So there are basically two types of investors. The first one are self-directed, which means that they know what to buy and where to buy it. And the second ones are managed clients, managed customers, that they want their money to be invested by a third party like Indexa Capital. So we believe that the number of self-directed clients is much smaller than the number of customers that need help with creating their portfolios. Having said that, being self-directed and buying your own index funds is also a very good option. It's a very good option as an investor as well. So what I would say is that from the asset management perspective, the way we invest and create our portfolios, and also the application and the usability that we have, that puts Indexa on a great advantage compared to other competitors that offer the same service, which is asset management, portfolio asset management.
Thank you, Unai. Maybe to add a couple of additional arguments, if you delegate the management of your fund index fund portfolio to Indexa, you will have access to the institutional class of the funds. And in the case of Vanguard, you even have access to the institutional plus class. What is institutional plus? It's a mutual fund that normally is accessible only to very large institutional investors, above 100 million per fund. And since we have this total amount among all our customers, and since we do discretionary portfolio management, Vanguard or other large asset managers, BlackRock, for instance, let us access to their institutional class. That means a lower fees on the funds. What you pay in portfolio management fees to Indexa, part of it is you spare it on the mutual funds fees. And the other argument is that we do the automatic rebalancing of the portfolio. You don't have to keep track of your portfolio and to keep the portfolio balance according to the weight you want to for your asset allocation. We do this automatically on a daily basis. And when there is a significant deviation to your objective portfolio, then we readjust, which increase the profitability or the risk return of your portfolio. So as Unai said, those are different services. The one is the self-catered, the other one is the delegated management, and both of those have their advantages, I would say. I don't know, Hugo, if this answers to the question.
Well, maybe to add in the meanwhile, if the question was more on how do we differentiate versus competitors, no, I would say it's about the brand equity. Okay, the brand equity supports transparency. The brand equity supports lowering the commissions every year, which is very different from other competitors and especially big, large financial institutions. And finally, the brand equity supports 10 years of track record, adding value to the clients. No, so all that is within the brand equity of Indexa, and obviously that is beginning to build a sustainable competitive advantage. Looking forward to the future.
Thank you, Ramón. We have a new question from Jorge Ayes. The question is whether we foresee any increase in capital in the near future. So we currently do not foresee a capital increase in the near future. The next foreseen capital increase would be very small and would be to convert the vendor debt of Caravel vendors into Indexa Capital Group shares. And we will probably do that next year. So we haven't foreseen a capital increase until then. The second part of the question of Jorge is whether a capital increase would help us to increase the free float. So maybe regarding the free float, you want to add something? Or
regarding the free float, we know that we need to work on the subject. We know that as of today, our free float is limited. And looking forward to the future is within our plans to increase the liquidity of the company.
Yeah, we will only do a significant capital increase if we find a company that we could acquire in good terms, and that would give us like a complete change in size. No? We haven't found that company yet. But this is something that could happen in the future, not in the short term, because right now we have no target or no idea. But this could happen in the long term.
Okay. So Hugo was precising that as a customer, he's already very happy with the service. The question was more as an investor in the company. So as an investor, comparing Indexa with other alternatives, I think our first differentiation is that we got to profitability earlier than we were the first independent automated investment service to reach profitability, probably in the world. Since then, there is another one that reached profitability in Japan. As far as we know, there is no other independent asset manager, automated investment services, profitable in Europe. Maybe they will have. But what we think is that not only we had to offer low fees to the customers, but we had to do it on a profitable way, so that our low fees are sustainable and can keep decreasing on the long term.
From the shareholder point of view, what we can say is that investing in Indexa Capital Group makes sense in order to ride with us. Okay, what we believe is going to be a massive inflow of assets to discretionary asset management, not only in Spain but also in Europe. We have already stated several times that we plan to be the number one independent asset manager here in the country. We expect to have significantly more alone in Spain than 10 billion euros assets under management, and that is a reason to invest in Indexa, not to surf the upcoming wave with us. I hope this answers your question. If any investor has a question that wants to post later on, we have a dedicated email, which is investors@indexacapital.com. Where we are very happy to answer any kind of questions from investors.
Also, the presentation that we have seen today is available on the group page. The group page is group.indexacapital.com, and that's the page for the investors. And you have it available in French, in English, and in Spanish.
There is also an Excel with the results that the people can download if they feel like it. If they wanna play with the numbers and forecast for the future. And of course, all the relevant legal information is also in this page.
There is a subscription option on the same page, group.indexacapital.com. The address is shared in the chat section. And with the subscription, you can put your email and be notified every time we publish a new document about the group, financial results, or other relevant information. Maybe we can wait a little bit to see if there is a last question or a couple, if any. Okay, you want to put a conclusion?
Yeah. So.
And if there is a question entering, we will keep answering. Yeah.
So first, thank you everyone for joining us this morning to hear about the Indexa Capital Group. Ramón has already explained us that you can make further questions at the following email, investors@indexacapital.com. So this year we are turning 10 years. We founded the Indexa Capital Group 10 years ago in 2014. So this has been a very, very interesting travel. We are really keen to see what the next 10 years, what is going to happen in the next 10 years. The numbers that we have shown you show that we are growing, that we are profitable, and also that we are accelerating, and we are really, really keen to see what the future is going to bring. So thank you again, and see you in 6 months.
If not before.
If not before.